Hello everyone, we will see how to schedule and trigger the Apache Airflow DAX. So it's not necessary that every time you will trigger manually, you should schedule it in some way. So I will show you how to schedule the Apache Airflow DAX. So for that, you should have this property schedule interval, which is currently by default none in our previous examples. So we can have it set with the various presets available, or you can give the cron expressions. So I will show you how. This is the preset which is already set, that the meaning of none is we cannot schedule this DAX and it can be triggered exclusively once, at the rate once. These are the annotations or presets, we can say. Once means schedule once and only once. So there are some setup jobs we can have in this category. Then there are some hourly injections, so we will have at the rate hourly, at the rate daily, at the rate weekly, at the rate monthly, and at the rate yearly. So if you can see, it runs once a week at midnight on Sunday. So they have their own preset. If you don't want this preset, you can directly give the cron expression to specify your needs. So generally this preset is very helpful. Otherwise, you have to provide the cron expressions. So if you want to get the details of cron expression for this particular weekly, you can check here. This is the cron expression for this weekly. So we also have used the similar preset now. So if you see in our code, this is a where flow example that we previously seen in our variables example. So here I added schedule interval at the rate hourly. So which means this DAG where flow is hourly DAG. So here also you can see schedule at the rate hourly, and on the DAX location you can also see schedule hourly. That means this DAG will run this ran on 7:18, so it will not happen before 8:18 now, because it has some previous runs, and it is, unless and until we trigger manually, it will not trigger. It will trigger only hourly. So this is one thing that we can have on scheduling perspective. And if you want a backfill and catch up, so sometimes you want to catch up the previous runs. So for that matter, you can use DAG.catchup true if you want to catch up from start date of the DAG to the current date. But usually if your DAG is running daily or periodically, you should have DAG.catchup false, because if it is true, that is a historical catch up or backfill. External triggers are something where we can run the DAG manually by typing the command airflow trigger DAG and then DAG name. So for that matter, we have taken one example in our bash map. We were having three scripts running one after the other. So in script 3, what I did is I entered this command airflow trigger DAG xconflow. So what I want is from bash map, and from step 3 of bash map, I will trigger xconflow by typing this trigger DAG command. So now if I trigger this bash map, so we will see. So go to graph view, you can see that first step is complete, and I have a scheduled, or I have written the command to trigger the xconflow from third bash script. Yeah, it's running. So we can check whether xconflow is triggered. Yeah, it's being on hold. It will trigger soon. See, it is started. So this is the xconflow we never triggered manually, but it triggered from the third step of bash map. So this is how we can schedule and trigger the flows. Thank you for watching. Let's data.